So in this class we are going to see object passing arguments. So as per our syllabus, we have seen definition of class and definition of object, the relationship between the object and object and class, and types of objects, how to declare object in a programming language. The next one is object as a arguments. So how passing the arguments, pass by value and pass by reference, we will see, especially in objects. Object as function argument. Already know about function arguments. What is the meaning of arguments? Arguments is nothing but variables. So we can call parameter also. Parameters or arguments or all variables, I think these all are same. So passing arguments and passing parameters, passing values, these all are same. We call in different names, but the meaning is the same. So object as a function arguments, it's nothing but You are passing object as a argument or as a variable or as a parameter. So we'll see how we passing object as a argument, as a function argument. This can be done in two ways. So object as a function argument, it can be done in a two ways. A copy of entire object is passed to the function. Copy of entire object is passed to the function. That is one way. The second one is only the address of the object is transferred to the function. Simple thing, I want to tell you one thing here. There is a variable A. Int a equal to 10. Imagine int a equal to 10. Here, just imagine a is the object. So we can pass this object in two ways. These two ways we call pass by value and pass by reference. What is the meaning of pass by value and pass by reference? If you pass the copy of a xerox or duplicate of a, the value of a to a particular function, that is called pass by value. Or the copy of entire object passing to the function, copy of entire object, so I already told a is the object. Now I make the duplicate of a, and that duplicate or that copy or that xerox I want sent to the particular function, and this way or this process we call pass by value. This is the one way how object can be passed to the as a function argument. And second way is called pass by reference. What is the meaning of pass by reference? How we can send object as a pass by reference? Simple. Here we are not making any duplicate, or we are not making any xerox, or not making any copy of the object, but we are sending address of the object to a function. We are sending address, not the value, but we are sending address. That's why this address we call pass by reference. Once we are changing the value, and another way you are sending the address. If you send the value, this is called pass by value. If we send the address, this one you call pass by reference. So here object as a function arguments, so we can done in two ways. The first one is pass by value and second one is pass by reference. Please listen carefully. Last year examination also there is a question, there was a question, explain the concept of pass by value and pass by reference. So pass by value and pass by reference, we can send variable as a pass by value or we can send arguments or parameters pass by value as well as pass by reference. Here we are sending the object as a function arguments to the another function in two ways. The first way is called pass by value and second way is called pass by reference. We will see one program, an example. Before going to see a program, let's look at here a definition of pass by value and pass by reference. A copy of an object is passed to the function. Any change made to the object inside of the function do not affect the object used to the local function. Object used to the local function. Why we are sending pass by value? Simple, I am telling you. So for example, if you understand this concept clearly, I want give real time example to you. What is the pass by value and pass by reference? For example, I have my course certificates with me. So my degree certificates with me. Now the all certificates are originals. Now I am taking the xerox of all my certificates. So I want to keep my original certificates inside of my house and I want to carry the xerox certificates wherever I go. Now if any modification I want to do, I can do on xerox. If I want to write anything, if I want to tear it, I want to change it, I want to submit to the anyone, I can do it. But what is the advantage here? Whatever I performing, the all work or task will not affect the original certificates. It may affect the xerox, but will not affect to my original certificates. So this is the benefit of the pass by value. I can use that value wherever I want, but any modification I want to do it, that modification will not affect the original value. So wherever you want, you can take the original value. Whatever the modification you want to do, you can do it in a duplicate. So in a duplicate you can modify it, but it will not affect to the original value. This way of using of the concept you call pass by value. Pass by value. Next one is the pass by reference. What is the meaning of pass by reference? Here we are not sending duplicate value, but we are sending only address of the original value. The address of the original value. So whenever a programmer want to utilize a particular location, a particular variable, simply it will link to the location of that variable. So simply it will go and use that memory location, it will go and use that one, that value. So we are not sending anything, but we are giving the connection or we are giving the link to that particular address of a value. So whenever it is required, it simply will go and access that particular reference or that particular address. In that particular address, what will be the value? That value he can use it, the programmer can use it. And this way of using of variables or object is called pass by reference. When an address of an object is passed, the called function works directly on the actual object used in the call. Means that any change made in inside that function will reflect in the actual object. Now listen, already in pass by value, if you want to do any modification on a Xerox or duplicate certificate, it will not affect to the original one. But here, pass by reference, you are giving the link to the original position, the actual position. If you want to perform any modification, now it will reflect to the original one. Why? Because you are directly accessing that location, you are directly using that variable. If you want to perform any modification here, it directly reflect to the original value. This is the difference between call by value and call by reference. So both you are using to passing of arguments, you know, object as function arguments. When you want to use object as a function arguments, we can do it in two ways. One is called pass by value and second one is called pass by reference. It's very, very important, because last year also this question was asked by SPT. So we'll see one small program here. Look at here. Passing object. How we are passing object? Hash include iostdumph class complex. What is the name of the class? Complex. Next, we are declaring data members. Float, real, image, both are the data members. And public, void get data, void put data. These two, void get data and void put data, both are the member functions. So data members and member functions, both are declared. Okay. Next, void sum, complex A and complex B. These both are what? These both are the function arguments. What these are? Function arguments. Void complex function arguments. Now listen, here, void complex put data, void complex get data are we accessing with the scope resolution operator. We accessing the get data and we accessing the put data in a class using of this scope resolution operator. So what is the scope resolution operator? It is given here, four dotted lines. These four dotted lines called as a scope resolution operator. When we want to use the scope resolution operator, when you want to access that data in all classes, when you want to access that particular data in all classes throughout the program, in that time you have to use the scope resolution operator. The scope resolution operator, it increases the scope of a member function. That means we can access not only one particular class, we can access outside of the class also. When you want to use the outside of the class, a particular member function, you have to declare that function in using of this scope resolution operator. So now look at here. So void complex sum, complex A and complex B, these are the parameters, these are the arguments. So now here A dot real plus B dot real, image equal to A dot image dot B dot image. So what? I am creating the object. So here three objects are there, X, Y, Z. In class complex, there are three objects. One is X, second one is Y, and third one is Z. Now, already function arguments are there above. In this object, we are passing the arguments. When you are passing the arguments, one function to another function. So this process is called pass by value and pass by reference, and passing of the objects, passing of the object, one function to another function, one function to another function within the class. And creating of the object, we are accessing that functions. How we are accessing that functions? So simple, we are creating three objects here, complex, xyz. So this is the way, or this is the syntax of how you create an object in a class. First, we have to follow the syntax. What is the syntax? Class name, then object name. When you mention the class name after object name, automatically you are doing a creating an object. Now, x dot get data, y dot get data, z dot sum, x comma y, and z dot put data. What happened? Simple. What are the data members you are declaring in a function, and you are calling that function using of the object, and automatically what is going on here? The all operations are performed while you are calling a functions through object. So this is program passing an object. This example of a program passing object. So we will see in detail manner how inside of the memory is working. When you are creating an object, how memory locations are allocated by the compiler, and how the x1, xyz are creating the space, and how they are accessing the members, you will see in detail manner. Look at here, the same programming. Here x is one object and y is another object, z is another object. I already told, when you're creating the object, it's nothing but you're creating one location or our memory location for that particular object. So that memory location for what? To storing of the data members and function and functions. Now listen here, x, y, z, three locations are there, three different places it will access the data members, or it will store the data members. Now listen, so once we create the location for data, now this locations or this memory is waiting for data. This memory is waiting for data for what? For storing of, for storing of data members, or for storing of values. Now x object, it's storing 5, 6 variable, and y object, it's storing 7, 8 object. Z is free because we are not allocating any values to the z object. So look at here. Now I want to do some performation. I want to do some task here. What is that? I want to add x comma y values. I want to come x comma y values, and I want to store that result in a object z. So I want to take some values in object x. I want to take some values in object y. Taking is nothing but assigning values to the object. Assigning values to the object to the function arguments. So here complex A and complex B, both are the function arguments, and I am sending some values to the function arguments, and then I want to use the object to storing the data values, and then this data value, the result of the data value, want to store in the object z. So look at here, x, y, z, A and B, those are the function arguments. Now this value is going to transfer to the another object. Now finally data is going to be stored in a z. When z accessing the data, because already mentioned here one function, z dot sum. Z dot sum, it is a function, z is an object, and sum is a name of the function, z dot sum. Then it adding the functions x comma y, x value, y value going to add. So then after adding of x comma y, the value going to store, or the result going to be stored in object z. Look at here clearly, it is given in detailed manner, in a mathematical way. The mathematical simplifications are given in memory locations, in object x and y, x storing 5, 6, and y here storing 7 and 8, and z is storing 12 and 4. Why? Simple, our procedure is to adding of x comma y values. What is the x value? 5. What is the y value? 7. The total of the x and y? 12. So that value going to store in z. It's clearly mentioned in detailed manner. You can understand the code of the program here, how the back end will work, how inside of the memory these values are storing, how the values are adding, how the values are transferring one location to another location, how the final result is storing in a object z. It's clearly mentioned. This way is called passing object. This way is called passing object. So now we want to see one more example for pass by value or passing parameter here. Passing parameter is nothing but pass by value. Here in this program, you can easily understand how we are passing object as a function argument. How we are passing object as a function argument here. We'll see a smart program. So here, look at here. Class square is the name of the class. What is the name of the class? Square. Square is name of a class. In this class, int x is a variable and void get data is a member function. So we are declaring data member int x and then access specifier public. Then void get data, we declaring a function also. So instead of the get data, there is a parameter that is called int m. We can call it as argument at the same time for a parameter. Now here in this parameter, this argument is a argument we can send to the another function. Another function is a what? Int answer is the another function. Okay, int answer is the another function. So now I am sending this value to here. The what value I am sending? The duplicate value I am sending. What value I am sending? Duplicate value I am sending. So here any modification happened, that modification will not reflect or affect to the original value. Simple here, int x is a variable we declare in the class square. Now I am creating x is equal to m. So x equal to m means m is the duplicate of x. X equal to m means m is the duplicate of x. Now what happened? I am using x here, x equal to x dot star, s dot star. This is the formula for square. So formula for square is x equal to x dot star, x dot star. So now what will happen? This modification will not affect the original x value. Simple, I am making the duplicate value of x, that is x equal to m. Now I using that x value, but it not reflect to the any original value. Simply passing the argument one function to another function. This way of passing the argument, function argument, object as a function argument, this is called pass by value. Pass by value. Next thing we will see, threatening objects. Threatening object nothing but pass by reference. Pass by reference. Pass by object is nothing but pass by value. Threatening object is nothing but pass by reference. So what is the pass by reference? Simple, I already told, linking of the address of the original value. Look at here. Hash include IO stream. Class sum. What is the name of the class? Sum is the name of the class. Next, again I declare in the variable int x. Int x is a variable. Now data, we can call the variable as a data member also. So here member function. What is the member function? Void get data is the member function. Void get data is the member function. And this member function will pass in the arguments. What are they? Int m. Int m is a argument. This function argument. Okay, this is a function argument. Now x equal to m, I am assign the value x equal to m. Look at here, sum s. What is sum s? Sum s is a function argument. Sum temp. Temp dot x equal to x plus dot x return temp. I am creating the temporary variable for storing of the values. creating temporary variable for storing of the values. While show answer is x. So int main sum x1, x2 and s3, s1, s2 and s3, these are the objects created. s1.getData, s2.getData, s3.s1.sum2, s3.show. Now we want to see the value of s3. Then now it will show the value of s3. What is the value of s3? s3 is the value stored in s1.sum2. s1, s2, both values will summation, and that value going to see in a s3 object. Here listen carefully. If I want to modify any value here, that value will affect or reflect to the original value. That value reflect to the original value. So we are passing the object. We are passing the object and function argument. We are passing the object as a function argument. S1, S2, S3 are the object. We are passing that S1 to S3. So S1 dot sum and S2. So we are passing the object, function arguments, passing the values. So in a first programming, now here it is the address passing, and this is called pass by value and pass by reference. Small programs, if you pass the duplicate of a variable as a function arguments, this is called pass by value. If you are sending the address of the value or variable or object, that is called a pass by reference. These two topics are very, very important for understanding of the concept as well as for exam orientation. These two concepts are very, very important. Thank you. We will see next topics in our next video lecture. Thank you.